Next up, you have an interview with an 80s legend.
I do. I caught up with Mark Holmand here at the Colston Hall. He was performing here with Jules Holland last week. So let's have a look at the interview that I did with him.
Sometimes I feel I've got to run away. I've got to get away from the pain you drive into the heart of me. The love we share seems to go nowhere. And I've lost my light, for I toss and turn, I can't sleep at night.
Mark, thank you for letting us in your dressing room.
Lovely to be here. I know it's a bit grim, I'm afraid, isn't
it's
it?
Okay.
Stuck in the basement.
We're happy
we
to have you here.
It's so nice to be here.
First of all, congratulations on an incredible career.
Oh,
over
thank
30
you very
million
much.
Records sold, still going strong.
Trying to, yeah, still going strong, I think.
Yeah. What's your secret?
I just love what I do. I just enjoy making music. I enjoy touring. I never get tired of it. There's always something new, and always some new adventure, or something new to do, or something you can do better as well. So
yeah.
I think it's just the thing. You just got to keep going and moving forwards, I think, and having as much fun as you can while you do it.
Yeah, and still learning as you're going.
Still learning. I kind of feel I'm still kind of learning things. And still, I love to do. I like to go and watch older performers, you know, and I like to watch them and people who, you know, the sort of legends of music and see.
What sort of people have you seen?
Well, I'm kind of like, you know, if you go and see, like, I mean, I saw Charles Aznavour recently.
Love
and I'm
Charles
a big,
Aznavour.
Massive Charles Aznavour fan. In fact, I might do a Charles Aznavour album in the next couple of years.
I'd buy that one.
And I've been to see him a lot of times, and just watching his stagecraft and watching the stagecraft of kind of the masters, you know.
Yeah.
And you can still pick up and you can say, yeah, that's how to do it.
Yeah, and it is. He does combine stagecraft with song, because he was never like a phenomenal singer.
He's a storyteller. Yeah. That's great. A storyteller. And his songs are great. I've always been a big, and I've recorded quite a few of his songs in the past. So.
Oh, fantastic.
He's great. A great
and
person.
I mean, you're a storyteller too. You love performing as much, almost it seems, as you do music.
Yeah, I do. I mean, I find that I'm most at home on the stage and then the studio. I mean, I like the studio process, but over the past years, it's become a very computerized thing, you know. It's nice when I did an album earlier this year with Tony Visconti producing. And he's a very old school producer, you know, has the band in the studio, rehearse, and then record. And then you do your overdubs. But now, so often, you do a record and it's a different way of working. You know, you work with computers and you work with kind of files and computers and things.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I did the new album, The Velvet Trail, very like that, with the producer Chris Braid, who lives in Los Angeles, and I live here. So we swapped files over emails and computers.
Yeah, yeah.
I never actually met each other until
really?
The end of the album.
But I
had actually met him before, because he did backing vocals on the Soft Cell album Cruelty Without Beauty. I never even realised
really?
It. And now he's producing Lana Del Rey and Britney Spears.
Fantastic.
and kind of all these people in Los Angeles. And he produced my album, co-wrote and produced the Velvet Trail album, which comes out, I think, in February.
How exciting. Well, let's talk about that. So what can your fans expect from your new album?
Well, I think it's a very kind of it's a return to kind of a very pop and rock and electro pop and electro rock and things. I did a lot of projects over the past few years, things like the Ten Plagues kind of opera projects, and I was here earlier in Bristol this year with John Hall doing the Tyburn Tree, very kind of prog rock kind of opera stuff, and I thought, I really want to get back to making some pop music songs, because that's how I became known. And that's how I started to like music, through pop music. So I thought, I wanted to, before it becomes undignified for me to do that, I want to make another pop record, you know, big choruses and big production. So that's The Velvet Trail, really. But it's also kind of personal as well. It's kind of melancholy but joyous at the same time, reflective. but also very dancey and very upbeat as well.
That sounds fantastic.
I think it's an album you could say is kind of very much the best of Mark Almond, taking some of the best bits, because Chris has been a fan of mine from over the years, and particularly Soft Cell and things, so we've put a lot of elements in that as well.
Yeah. In terms of writing the album then, you talked about the different flavours of it. How is creativity for you these days? Is it something that you've kind of nailed after 3 decades in the industry, or does it still elude you from time to time?
I still want new challenges, and I'm always looking for new challenges all the time. When I did things like the Ten Plagues project, I never thought I could do this opera, one-man opera, all on my own. That was just, I can't do this. But I kind of worked on it and I did it, and I learned so much from doing that. Working with John Hall as well earlier this year on Tyburn Tree, and I did another opera in Paris, Poppea, which is like a rock version of the Coronation of Poppea, which was a Monteverdi opera. And then it was taking me to all these new fields, and I love that. I love to learn new things and try new things and things that are going to challenge me. And I think in music, if you're going to last, always be prepared to fall flat on your face at times, you know, and prepared to take risks.
Good advice.
Because then you kind of like, you learn something and you move on. Yeah. You've got to have the failures as well as the successes.
Yeah. Stretch your comfort zones and learn from them.
Yeah.
Yeah, great advice. So where can people see you coming up? So you've got a date. So you're here tonight with Jules Holland.
I'm on tour with Jules Holland at the moment, yeah. Well, I've done quite a few tours with Jules. This, I think, is the best one I've done with Jules. It's a very upbeat show. Jules sings lots of new songs. My spot in the show is very kind of high energy. I'm doing kind of some Jules style versions of a couple of my older classics songs, as well as a great Edith Piaf song I do.
So people
have missed us in Bristol. I think they can probably get to see us in Cardiff. December the 20th,
great.
Which is the last date of the tour. Yeah. So it'll be like a Christmas party. Yeah. It'll be a real kind of a great gig to go to, I think.
That'd be awesome. So if you're watching Made in Cardiff, then perhaps you can go and see Mark then.
And you can see me.
Yes, and you can see you here next April.
23rd of April. Yep. I'll be back here at the Colston Hall, Bristol. And it seems like I'm living here these days, actually. I've been here with John Hall earlier this year, two dates with Jules, my own show in April. So I might just move in.
It's a great place to live, Mark. We'd welcome you here. But it's a great venue.
I love the venue. And it's always great sound here and a great audience. So I just love to come here. So it's always on my list when I do a tour.
Yeah, brilliant. Well, we look forward to welcoming you back here next April. Tickets are on sale now for your tour.
They're on sale. And the Velvet Trail album is out in end of February.
Great.
I think. And they can also get, I did a mini album earlier this year, which I'll also be doing a few numbers from on the tour, called The Dancing Marquis, which is songs by produced by Tony Visconti, Jarvis Cocker, and various things. So that's still out there too.
Great. Well done. Thank you so much for joining us.
It's my pleasure.
Have a great show tonight.
Thank you very much.
We'll see you next April.
Lovely to talk to you.
Thank you.